Hello, assalamu alaikum. In previous classes, we have been discussing about JavaScript and JavaScript functions, variables, and how we use JavaScript to validate the forms. Today, basically, we will be talking about one of the major concepts within JavaScript called document object model. Sometimes we discuss this a little later on, but I like to discuss it a little early because this is something that we've been using and we will be using in various different examples as well. So it's better to understand exactly how JavaScript is working with respect to document object model, and we will discuss various aspects of this model: what are window, what is object, what's methods, what's property, how we use the document as an object within our JavaScript. I'm Dr. Dishan Birdie. If you're here for the first time, kindly don't forget to subscribe this channel and hit that bell icon so that you receive the latest videos and updates regularly. Let's begin. Now, every web page resides inside a web browser. We all know that, okay? Which can be basically considered as an object, okay? A document object represents the HTML document that is displayed in that particular window. A document object has various properties that refers to other objects, which allow access to and modification of that particular content. The way that document content is accessed and modified is called document object model, or DOM. The objects are basically organized in what we call a hierarchy. The DOM is basically a W3C consortium standard document object model. Document object model defines a standard for accessing documents. In other words, okay, we can say that it's a standard, it's a protocol, it's a set of rules that defines us that how you can access a document. Again, a document being a particular web page. So whenever we refer to a document with respect to JavaScript or with respect to DOM, basically we are referring to a particular web page. So a W3C document object model is a platform and language natural interface that allows programs and scripts to dynamically access and update the content, structure, and the style of documents. Same thing, basically meaning that if I explain it in clear words, that it's an interface, it's a programming rules that allows us to define how we can dynamically access and update various different contents in a particular web page. Okay, so that web page or that content can be any content using HTML or even CSS. So any content that is existing on a web page, how we change those content, what are the rules, methods, and modifications that you use, you can basically specify it with respect to DOM model. Okay. So this is basically a model. It's not a core like a core language. It's just a model or a standard that allows us to explain and define various different concepts within a particular web page. W3C DOM standard is separated into three different parts. First being core DOM, second XML DOM, and third HTML DOM. Core DOM standard model for all document types, all web pages in other words. A standard model is for XML documents only. So XML document is basically, or XML DOM is basically specified for XML documents. So if you're working with XML, you would be using XML DOM. HTML DOM, standard model for HTML documents. Okay. So specifically web pages only. So majorly we are concerned and we will be discussing primarily HTML DOM in detail. This hierarchical structure applies to the organization of an object in a web document. Again, a document or DOM model basically provides a hierarchical structure that allows us to separate various different elements within a web page in a hierarchy. This hierarchy structure is what we are referring here. The window object, for example, is the top of hierarchy. It is the outmost element of the object hierarchy. Then we have something called document object. Then we have something called a form object, and then form control elements. Each of these components are basically referred to as a document object model elements. Okay, if I come here, I think I will be able to explain it in more form. Again, this is what a typical document object model looks like. It represents a hierarchy of components that allows us to control and use them. So for example, at the top of the hierarchy is a window, which basically is your browser window, any browser window for that matter. It's not specific to a single browser. So any browser window, and that might have a frame, a parent, a self, and a top, four major attributes. Frame being individual frames within the window, a parent frame, a parent window, in other words, self being it's the self page that is being currently visible, and the top frame. So window object is usually residing on the top of the hierarchy. Then we have something called a history document and the location. History, as you all know, every web page maintains a history, so it keeps a track of web pages that we have basically been accessed. Majorly, we work with this thing called documentation. Document is basically your web page. This is what we will be working. So we work with window, then we come to the document, which refers to the web page, each single web page within your browser. Then this web page is again further broken down into hierarchy. We have links, we have forms, we have anchor tags, we have div tags, for example, and then so on and so forth. Document has a form tag. Form again has multiple other tags. For example, link has no subtag. If a paragraph has no subtag, headings might have subtags like heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4. We can say those can be used as a sublinks, but usually it's just a simple thing. Similarly, image tags. So a document can contain lots of tags, and so all hierarchy items are not mentioned here. But then there are some tags that have a subtag. For example, form tag. Form has items. Form has types of input items, which means radio buttons, text area, password fields, reset, button, and all and so forth. We can have tables, for example, here as well. So a document may contain a table. A table has a sub-items called table, rows and table, columns, table, headers, table, footers, for example. Then a document may also have lists, which may contain ordered list or unordered list. Then each ordered and unordered list contains list items, and so on and so forth. So basically, this defines as the hierarchy in which each component may be accessed. So if you need to access, for example, a select or a text field within a particular document, or you need to read the content of an element, this text field. So what you do is you go inside your document. Inside the document, you go into the form. From inside the form, you go into that text field. So you have to follow the hierarchy to access a particular text field which belongs to a form inside a particular document, which then again is inside a particular window for that matter. Okay, so this is a hierarchy that you need to follow, and this is what we need to understand. So in previous class, we also had used what we called reading data from form, and we did a similar thing where we used document.forms, and then within forms we had used a two-dimensional array defining the form name and the text field name, and then dot value which read the form. So basically we try to follow the same hierarchy. Okay, then if you understand the HTML DOM more, specifically the HTML DOM is basically again considered as a tree hierarchical structure. This hierarchical structure contains document, then the root element is HTML. We all know that every HTML document starts with an HTML tag. Then within the HTML tag, we have two subtags called head tag and body tag. That's it. So this HTML tag has a major element called head and second most called body. Head may contain title, head may contain text title area, or title, for example, head may contain the link tags, head may contain the script tag, head may contain other metadata tags. The title, for example, then contains the text itself. So each text is there. Similarly, if you go into inside the body contains, for example, 8 anchor tag. The anchor tag contains hreference, my link text. The body also contains heading 1, which contains the text. It contains paragraphs, it contains div tags, tables, and so on, so forth. So the major aspect here is that in order to use this tag, in order to use this text, in other words, for using JavaScript, okay? So for example, you need to read this text, or you need to change this text, or you need to process this text using JavaScript. In order to access this text, you have to follow the hierarchy. You cannot directly access this text. You need to understand this hierarchical structure defines that within our HTML, every component has a hierarchical structure. So you need to follow that structure. Again, by that meaning, remember we use something called document.getElementById. So which means document, this is the main object, these are the various elements of that object. So inside document, getElementById. So this is an element, get an element that has ID called whatever ID we specify, for example, test. Then that ID will be returned by having this particular tag. Then we use the property called .innerHTML. We will show you examples with that. So this is the inner HTML. So in order to access this inner HTML, we used inner HTML with the get element by ID, which belonged to a particular document, following the hierarchy. Okay, hopefully it explains it. What exactly is the HTML DOM? The HTML DOM is a standard object model and a programming interface for HTML. It defines that an HTML element as an object, the meaning basically that each HTML element that you have, it behaves like an object as well. So each HTML element basically behaves like an object, and you can access its value by its properties or by its methods. Okay. So each element behaves like an object. The properties of HTML elements. Okay, so basically each element has its properties. So this text is basically property of this element. This my link is a text that appears on your link where you see the visible link, you click on this link. This link basically is the property. So this is an object, this is a property. The method to access all HTML elements. Then we have something called a method. The methods are used to access all the HTML elements. In order to use this element or access this element, I need to have some methods which are referred through the object. So methods are basically used to access the elements. The properties are used to access the data inside those elements or the values inside those elements. Then we have called something events for all HTML elements. Every HTML elements also has an event, like on click, like mouse over, like mouse exit, like mouse click, mouse enter, and so on and so forth. So there are various different events, various different methods, various different properties, and various different objects. Using DOM model, we basically work with these three basic principles. This is something that we have already been talked about in our previous classes as well, and this is what we talk about again. Object basically contains methods which allows us to change the properties of HTML elements. Simply as that. Okay. In other words, the HTML DOM is a standard for how to get, change, add, or delete an HTML element. So in a simple words, if we redefine or again define it in a simple words, we say that what is a DOM? HTML DOM, document object model. This model basically defines a standard or a protocol or a way by which you would be able to get the data from an HTML element or change the data of an HTML element. Element means HTML tag, or add something to that HTML tag, or HTML delete that HTML tag. Okay, so how should you do that? That's the standard you need to understand, and that standard is again defined by the DOM model. Okay, so that's what DOM does. Okay, it's just a simple model allowing us to understand what we can do and what we cannot do and how we can do it. So with an object model, JavaScript gets all the power it needs to create a dynamic HTML. Okay, so basically by using this DOM, we have an access to something called object. Okay, and with this object, we get the entire power to do all these things that we just discussed. With this object, we are able to use the methods and property feature and the event feature for that matter. So basically, this DOM defines then object structure, that everything within your web page is an object. Then in order to work on that object, you have methods, you have properties, and then you can use them together to create whatever or change whatever and modify whatever you want to do. So what we can do with that, we say the JavaScript can change all HTML elements in a page. So remember, using this objects and methods as approach, you can change every single HTML element in a page, no matter what it is. It's a div, it's a table, it's a row, it's ordered list, unordered list, it's an anchor tags, it's a tags, it's image tags, or whatever you want to do, you can change that. JavaScript can change all the HTML attributes in a page as well. So whatever attributes you use, for example, the color, the size of the fonts, or image source, for example, anchor tag links, or height and width attributes, any attributes that you have within your HTML tag, JavaScript can change that. So you have a one page, but JavaScript, as the user performs his actions, the page is being changed based on the user actions or whatever they are doing or however we want to drive it. JavaScript can do that, make our page dynamically change. JavaScript can change the CSS style as well. So remember, JavaScript can access your CSS and change the styles as well. So it is not only talking about HTML, the same applies on CSS. JavaScript can remove existing HTML elements and attributes as well. So if you have defined already HTML elements, JavaScript can remove them, delete them, change their content, change their attributes, change their properties. JavaScript can add new HTML elements and attributes as well. So you can embed HTML elements within your JavaScript code as well that will be adding new elements inside it. JavaScript can react to all existing HTML events in a page as well. So all the existing events that you have in your HTML page, JavaScript can react to that and generate a dynamic response based on your actions. So for example, mouse over, mouse exit, enter, mouse click, mouse release, mouse whatever actions that are we can perform, anything. Okay, can be basically controlled and reacted based on JavaScript or using JavaScript. Finally, JavaScript can create a new HTML events in a page as well. So it has the functionality of creating new events that typically HTML might not have. Okay, and we will see examples of each as we go along. For example, JavaScript has to change the elements. We have done that. We have changed the content of our paragraph tags. We have changed the attributes. For example, I think we have not changed attributes. We will be changing attributes and styles as well, and adding and deleting existing elements and all that. So in future classes, you would see that we basically are able to do lots of things with JavaScript. And all those basically are done based on the same psychology and principle that it's following the DOM model. Okay, so that's a basic typical of DOM model. So now what we can do is we write something called document. Now, as discussed in DOM, document is an object that refers to your web page. So within DOM, this is how it defines it, that in order to access this paragraph, you need to follow a hierarchy. That hierarchy is that you go inside a web page, you access its HTML. Within that HTML tag, you access its inner HTML. So we access the web page. Then we wrote document.get element by ID. Now this get element by ID basically is a method that allows us to get an element of HTML. Okay, so this is a method, this is an object. So within this object we have a method called get element by ID. What this method does is it fetches an element within our HTML that has a particular ID. So we give it the same ID, para one. Now we have told it that find an HTML that has called ID para 1. So it will go and it will find that ID para 1. Now remember, within your HTML there can be many paragraph tags. Within your HTML there can be many tags itself. But when we use an ID, we have to be ensured that each paragraph has a unique ID. So there can be 10 paragraph tags. However, each paragraph will have a different unique ID. So in this case, if I use 3, 4, 5, 6 paragraphs, each paragraph, if I use the same ID, it might create a problem for me. So what we do is, we try to go and change the ID in terms of its name. Okay. So this is ID 1, ID 2, para ID 3, para 4, para 5. So now each paragraph has a unique ID. So we can access each paragraph uniquely as well. So this is what the DOM tells us to do, that use an object, within this object use a method to access a particular HTML tag or HTML element. Then use dot property called inner, for example, HTML. Now inner HTML is basically a property. This property is a value that you can get or set. This property, through this property, you can get a value or set a value to an HTML tag. So this is a method, this is a property. A method is basically an action that you perform on an HTML tag. So method, using a method, you can perform certain actions on HTML tag, which in this case is we are retrieving that HTML tag that has a particular ID, and there are numerous methods available. This is one method. Then we have an inner HTML. This is what we refer to as a property. A property can, what we say, add a value, delete a value, subtract a value, or change a value. Okay. So in this case, we want to change the value or set a value. In other words, if you want to use the word. So we can say, hello DOM, and then we give a element column. So what we are doing here is we are using that DOM approach to change the value of a paragraph. So this is something we have already talked about in previous classes. We have used it in previous classes. We are just reshaping it and telling it now. What you have been doing is actually doing it by what we call DOM protocol or DOM standard, document object model. So this is what document object model tells us to do. Simple as that. Okay. So this is what we did as per document object model. Keeping in mind, this is what we refer to as a property. This is what we refer to as an object. Okay. Similarly, there are many properties that we can change. Similarly, there are many methods that we can use with document object. Now, if I press S and go into the browser, you would find Hello DOM object available. Now, what we have done here is we have accessed this document and we have changed its property. Okay. We have changed the paragraph that exists within this and changed its element. We can even go inside the heading one and change it, for example. So I can come here, I can say document dot get element by ID. Now again, in order to access this h1, we have to use an attribute called ID equals bracket start bracket close. We have to give it some name. So for example, I can say ID head head one. So this is my ID head one. So I come here, give it a bracket, inverted quotations, ID head one is my ID. So again, using the same protocol, go into the document, find an element that has ID called ID head one. It's not concerned which element it is. It can be any element. That's why we say that using JavaScript, you can change any element. It's not concerned with the element, it's concerned with the ID. So it will fetch that particular element. Then what you do with that element, you have to know. For example, if it is an image, we change the SRC. If you need to change the image, so you won't not access its HTML, but you want to change the SRC. If you are changing an anchor link, so you have to find for the hreference, for example. I will give you a few more things to do in later classes. So in this case, we go inside in our HTML and we can change the string here, and we can only say document, in this case, document object modl model DOM only, control S. If I come back here into my code, now I only have document object model. Okay, so previously it was JavaScript document object model, now it's only document object model. So we change the inner HTML of an heading tag. We can do that very simply, very easily. Similarly, you can also change the content of your image as well. So for example, we have an image within our HTML page. Okay, so you can even change that as well. But before going into that, let's discuss more about document itself. So if I come here and you write document, if you write document document, okay, dot, as soon as you press dot, again, because I'm using an editor, you get lots of methods. So for example, there is method that we use called get element by ID. Now this is a method that we have used commonly. However, there are other methods as well by using get. So we can use, or we can get an element by its class name as well. So if you are specifying a method by a class name for CSS, you can even get that element by a class name as well. So you don't need ID, but you can use a class name as well. Even you can use get element by ID. What this does, by names, for example, or by tag name. Okay, ID is what we use ID, and you can also use name tag as well. So for example, if you specify name here, equals name, and I can say para bio, right? So this is my biography para, and save it. So I can use the method called dot get and then get by name. So what this we do, it tries to get the attribute or property by the name value. Okay, so or tag name as well, or tag name in form of, for example, if you come here, NS as well. Okay, I usually don't know what NS stands for, but if I wanted to actually read the help out, if I come here, go back here, okay, returns a list of elements with a given tag name belonging to a given namespace. Okay, so basically it means that you specify not the full name, but a certain names, and it will return all the elements by it. Okay, not one, but multiple elements. Okay, so you can use multiple ways of getting your information. Again, primarily we have used ID. I have used ID more often, but you can use class name. Again, classes names are same that we specify for CSS. So if you are specifying a paragraph name with a CSS style, for a CSS class, you can use that same class name here as well, or you can use it by name as well. So if you are using name as an attribute to identify a individual tag, that can also be used, no problem with that. Okay, so it's not necessarily that we always go for ID tag. Similarly, there's a get selection, register element, document fragments. There's a lots of methods that we use in order within our document tag. Okay, then if you talk about the elements, for example, okay, in other words, if I have get dot get element by ID, and I specify the ID, for example, ID, voila, ID head, head head one, then I use dot. Now dot is basically when I use the second dot, now it doesn't use the methods, now it tries to fetch the elements. So for example, we have talked about inner HTML. Now this is what the inner properties refer to. This basically means inside a document, there is a get method. Inside that method, there is a sub method, if you talk in terms of Java. So this is like a method within a method or class within a class. So it's like document dot method, then dot access the subclass method. Okay. So in this case, in JavaScript, in simple terms, we are referring to it as a property. So we have an object. Object is connected with your method. Method is connected with your property. Property basically changes the content of your HTML tag. Okay. Element basically accesses the attributes. The method basically accesses the attributes. Okay. In other words, when we use the methods, here we write methods. So after document dot method comes. Method is basically accessing the methods or attributes within your tag. So as all the attributes that we write, basically are able to access it. Okay. Then when we write inner HTML, this is what we refer to property. Property means whatever you write between the start tag and ending tag. Okay. So it's trying to fetch those inner HTML content, the content of your actual tag. So it's trying to read that. Once you read it, once you access it, you can change it, you can modify it, you can delete it, you can whatever want to do it. Okay. So inner HTML is something we use to change the content of our HTML tag. It's a property. If we refer it to as property, that changes the content of your HTML elements. Then there are other things as well. So for example, in order to change the attribute, we use something called attribute tag, A-T-T-R-I-B-U-T-E. Okay. I think simple attribute, right? Get attribute, has attribute, set attribute. See, these methods are there. So you can get an attribute, you can check a particular attribute, you can set a value of an attribute. You can use these methods, or you can just use a simple attribute as well. So attributes as well. So you can get the collection of all attribute nodes registered to that specific node. So point of saying again is there are multiple methods that you need to explore, and then you can need to check with it. Okay. Similarly, for example, there's method called set attribute. This set attribute would basically change the attribute value of an HTML element. So if I use a set attribute, it adds a new attribute or changes the value of an existing attribute. So in order to change something from a paragraph content, not the inner, but these attribute values. So for example, you can change the name of an ID or HTML tag. You can do that by using a set attribute. Okay. Or you want to change the name or attribute or the values within this particular paragraph, or for example, list items or image items or anchor tags. We use these attributes. So there are numerous methods that we can play around with. Similarly, there are other elements like creating, for example, get element by ID. We have not in this thing, but if you delete this, we have something called dot create attributes as well, which will allow us to create an attribute. We can have create element as well. If I come here, there is one called element, create element. Okay, creates a specified element. Okay, we can even remove elements, we can remove childs, we can write. Usually this is something that we use commonly, w-r-i-t-e, write, which is basically used to write some data on a HTML and on your web page. Okay, so there are various different methods that we have applied and we have used. Similarly, finding various different objects and other methods, basically, for example, we have we can use in order to access the forms, we use something called forms element object or forms method. So if you are going to access your forms, you need a form method. If you are going to access your head, you need to access write the head. Okay, so the hierarchy, remember, if I told you that we have a hierarchy structure, so document is your main document. Every HTML tag has its hierarchy. So every HTML tag exists there. So if you need to change the content of your head tag, this is where you need to go. You can write the body, and then you can go inside the, it will return the body element, and you can change the contents of your body element. You can even write forms, and then whatever forms you have created within your HTML tag, you can change that. If you have images, you can change the images as well. So IMAGES, images, image smoothing, enable border images, I think you can change that as well. So document can be used even for links as well. You can use that. So all the anchor tags, you can change that as well. Okay. Some of the examples we will be doing later on in various different tasks. So this is just a general overview what DOM allows us to do. So DOM says that use a document and then use an OB methods. So each element tags or each attributes has various different methods that you can use, and you can work with that. Okay. Then within, once you have accessed the methods, we go inside something called elements, and we work with these elements or properties to change the content of our HTML. Remember, you can change the text like we did right now, but you can also change, for example, you can read the content as well. I hope you understand up till here. Again, any confusion in this, we will be talking in next class. In the next session, I will try to give more examples of each of the concepts that we have discussed right now. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe so you receive the next videos. And we will talk about more examples and how we use all these elements and objects in next class. Thank you very much for watching.